Hello and welcome to Just One More Watch. Welcome to what is a bit of a special video. Special for me anyway. 20,000 subscribers, who knew? Back when I started this channel, I thought, maybe I can max out at 20k eventually. So to be here already is fantastic. And that's all thanks to you, obviously. So thank you. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for watching the videos. Thank you for commenting. Thank you for liking. Thank you for disliking. There is no ban hammer here. You can say pretty much whatever you like in the comments as long as you don't swear at me. I only have the opinion of one man after all, and I love the banter that goes back and forth in the comment section. I'm still learning with every single video that I make, especially as I'm focused on this value end of the market. With every watch I review, I'm able to discern even better the good from the bad, from the meh. And if I can help you make more informed watch purchasing decisions, then all the better. If you get the odd chuckle here and there, then that is also a good thing. So thank you again. So 20K then, what am I going to do today? Well, obviously I have to do some kind of watch giveaway. I gave a watch away for 5K, I gave a watch away for 10K. So what am I going to do for 20K? One of the favorite videos that I made last year was a three-piece budget watch collection for less than $150, proving once again you don't have to spend a fortune to get not one, but three fantastic watches to choose from. So today I'm going to give away a three-piece watch collection. One dressy, classy piece for the office, Monday to Friday, 9 to 5. One more robust and waterproof offering for the weekend, and a bonus watch. And I thought to make it a little more personal, from me to you, I would give away three watches that mean something to me. Two of them you'll find in my State of the Collection video from December 2017 that I paid my own cash for. The other one, I put a lot of love, a lot of time, and a lot of attention into this little watch. And now I'm going to give them all away with enough straps and accessories to keep one of you lucky viewers amused for a fair amount of time to come. So what do you have to do to win a watch collection then? Well, I'll let you know at the end of the video. Let's flip the camera and get into it. Oh my goodness, look at all this horological goodness. So much stuff that I'm giving away today, I can barely get it all into one shot. This is going to make two people very happy indeed. Two people? Why two people, I hear you ask, Jody? Well, the first is the lucky winner. The second is my wife, when she realizes how much watch-related paraphernalia is about to leave the house. So true to my word, I'm giving you three watches, an entire collection, a whole bunch of straps, a three-watch travel pouchy thing here. The only thing not included in the shot today that I'm going to give you is a spring bar remover. I've got one of those in my drawer at work. I'll include that in the package as well. We have got a Seiko-powered sapphire crystal dress watch with day-date complication as your Monday to Friday 9 to 5 piece. We've got a 200-meter legendary Soviet-era dive watch as your weekender. And we've got a Swiss automatic, frighteningly accurate, with a 90-hour power reserve as your bonus watch. Am I generous or what? One from China, one from Russia, one from Switzerland, all of them with stories to tell. And isn't that part of the fun about watches, telling the stories? So first up then, it's the Guan Chin, or more specifically, my Guandor, my beloved little Guandor. Now this one came to me supplied by GearBest as a review sample, but there's a whole lot of love that has gone into this little watch since then. So I'm going to give you, on the original pure 100% toad leather strap, I'm going to chuck in a NATO, a Perlon, and it's currently sitting on this rather natty vintage leather style strap from Sectime in the UK. Also included original packaging, including one of those funny little Guan Chin world's smallest polishing cloths there. So this little Guan Chin is a bit of a YouTube sensation. Over 50,000 people have watched a video of this one, whether it's my original review, whether it was the mod vid where I swapped out the original hands for that fine looking set of snowflakes, or the crystal test where I proved that this was in fact a piece of genuine sapphire crystal. all for the incredible price of $62. I will leave a link in the description for this one. If you haven't already picked yourself up one of these, you probably should before GearBest jack up the price, especially considering that is a genuine Seiko NH36 through the display case pack. I really like the Guanqin. I think it's an elegant looking watch, and for once, it's a Chinese watch that isn't trying to be something else. And you know, it's got a whiff of Longines about it. There's a few Citizens and Seikos of the past that it may have referenced, but this unique polygonal style bezel is very much its own thing, the Guanqin. I think it's a really classy looking watch. Applied indices, sunburst on the dial there, 20 mil lug width. I think it really suits that vintage strap today. Also, I popped on the snowflake hands to add a little bit more lume, adds a bit more practicality, far more legibility as well due to the sheer volume of those new hands. But a cracker, the Guanqin. I really do enjoy this watch, and I hope that its new owner gets as much out of it as I have over the last 6 months. And there it is, on wrist for probably the last time today. 40 millimeters diameter, looks great on my 7-inch wrist. A great size for most people, I think. Those kind of claw lugs do mean that it wears slightly large, but not disproportionate, and I think it really suits that strap. Also looked good on a NATO when I dressed it up for the mod video, so I'm including one of those in the package as well, along with the original strap and a pearl on as a bonus for a bit of color if you fancy that. Next up then, it's your weekend watch, and what better weekender than the Vostok Amphibia. This one, the 710634, the Scuba-Doo dial and the Ministry case, was the first Vostok I bought last year. I picked this one up from Mikhail at Moscow Time Sellers, so this one, paid with my own cash, arrived all the way from Moscow to Sydney and then on to its new owner, supplied with the original Vostok box, spare links for the uber shiny bracelet in there. I'll also chuck in a couple of rubber straps. I would suggest you take it straight off that hair nipper and get it onto one of these. This one sized for my 7-inch wrist, this one brand new, unsized. And we've got a cracking monkey swag NATO strap if you want to pop it on one of those instead. There are many good reasons why these Vostok Amphibia have a cult following within the watch community. They are quirky, they are characterful, they are cheap, and they are plentiful. I paid about $65 for this one, which is an incredible price for a genuine, fully automatic in-house movement with date complication, 200 meters water resistance. We've got a mixture of chromed brass and stainless steel, super, super shiny bracelet. There aren't too many bracelets shinier than this one. It's fairly nasty as well and will remove most of your arm hairs if you let it, but I hear the bracelets themselves have got a bit of a cult following, so each to their own. My favorite feature on these Amphibia is that domed acrylic crystal. Distorts the dial magnificently. This one, as you can see, has got a couple of scuffs, a couple of scratches on there, but we don't call them scratches on a Vostok, we don't call them patina either, we call them character. This watch was really made for that. Unique design as well, actually gets more water resistant the more pressure you put this watch under. Just fantastic and eminently modifiable. You can swap out the bezels, the crowns, the dials, the hands, you can create your own unique Vostok. All too easy to start with one and end up with three or four of these things, so this one out the door to somebody new. And just look at that thing on wrist, a proper blast from the past. You can wear this one around town pretending you're straight out of a Soviet era spy movie if you so desire. 41mm diameter, but these cushion cases do that thing where they just disappear on the wrist as well. 22mm lug width, plenty of tapered down to that bracelet, but do take my advice about the hairs on your arms or you'll soon have a bald patch if you stick to this original one. Super shiny, super Soviet, super Russian, super Vostok. And finally, the bonus watch, and what a bonus this one is. The iconic Swatch brand is their first automatic. It's the first Swiss watch to be manufactured entirely by robots rather than handmade. But we've got Swiss made on the dial. We've got a 90-hour power reserve, and these things are incredibly accurate. The story is that they could have gone for COSC certification. They're that good, but it costs so much money, and it's not something that was necessarily going to appeal to Swatch buyers anyway, so they didn't bother. But a truly innovative timepiece, this one, from the Swiss giants. I picked this one up myself when I was back in Glasgow on holiday, so nae messing with this one, by the way. 42 millimeters in diameter, but light as a feather due to its all plastic construction. This one, the system red, those little red star pattern looks like a constellation there on the dial, representing some of the rubies, some of the jewels used by the movement. And the movement is pretty special. You can see the beating heart of it there and that funky stripy rotor all the way around the outside. 51 moving parts, all held together by a central screw. Massive power reserve, just a phenomenal piece of engineering. This one includes that unique Swatch integrated bracelet there as well. And there is my System 51 on wrist for the last time. Super light, light as a feather, really don't feel like you're wearing a watch at all. Incredibly comfy given that stitched rubber strap as well. Fantastic summer watch if indeed you live somewhere that does have a discernible summer. If you're from the UK, perhaps you can wear it on your annual fortnight holiday to Spain instead. But a lovely watch, the System 51. I hope its new owner appreciates it.
So there you have it, a fantastic starter collection for somebody. Three versatile pieces, all bases truly are covered by these three. So what do you have to do to win it then? Well, it's very simple indeed. All you have to do is
watch all of my videos forever.
Only kidding. All you have to do is let me know which of my 140 odd videos is your favorite and why. Leave me a comment below. It's not purely a vanity exercise, I promise. It'll help me shape the content on the channel over the coming months and hopefully years to come. I'll announce the winner in 1 week's time. I'll pin the comment, leaving my email address, telling the lucky subscriber to get in touch, and I'll send them that juicy package full of horological goodness. Thanks again. Thank you all for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Hopefully I'll see you in a future video.